Good afternoon, children. Children, today we are going to continue with our topic empirical formula. But along with that, we are going to do one more new thing. That is, after calculating the empirical formula, we'll be given in the numerical to calculate the molecular formula also. So this type of question we are going to practice today. First, I'll tell you one numerical, then I'll give you one more to practice, and you'll do both of them in your fair notes. So let's see the numerical. The numerical says, an organic compound contains carbon 16.27%, hydrogen 0.677%, chlorine 72.2%, and rest is oxygen. Its vapor density is given here. This vapor density is a new thing which has been included. I'll explain you that. Its vapor density is this. Find its molecular formula. And atomic weights are given in the question. So you have to find the molecular formula. But before that, you have to calculate the empirical formula also. For finding molecular formula, empirical formula has to be calculated, found. So first we will see what is this rest of oxygen. So finding out the percentage of oxygen, what are we going to do? 100 minus percentage of carbon 16.27% plus hydrogen 0.677% plus chlorine 72.2%, and that is actually equal to 10.8%. So you have got the percentage of oxygen. Now what are you going to do? Now we will be doing that table. Elements, percentage, atomic weight, relative number of atoms, and then simplest ratio. So this table we are going to make. That is the table. We'll put the elements: carbon, hydrogen, chlorine, oxygen. Carbon 16.27%, hydrogen 0.677%, chlorine 72.2%, and rest oxygen, that is 10.8%. Now atomic weights are 12, 1, 35.5, and 16. What are we going to do to find relative number of atoms? We will be dividing the percentage by atomic weight. So 16.27 divided by 12, 0.677 divided by 1, 72.2 divided by 35.5, and 10.8 divided by 16. So these values, when we calculate, the values will be coming as 2.04. This is coming at 2.04. Then 0.675. So these are the values of relative number of atoms. Relative number of atoms we have got. Now we will find out the simplest ratio. To find out the simplest ratio, what are we going to do? We will be simply finding out the smallest figure and dividing all of them with the smallest figure. That is 1.35 divided by 0.672, 0.672 divided by 0.672, 2.04 divided by 0.672, 0.675 divided by 0.672. So this is coming as 2.131. So these are the values for simplest whole number ratio of the atoms, and thus we will get the empirical formula. So the empirical formula is, empirical formula of the compound is C2H Cl3O. So till here you have done earlier. you know how to calculate the empirical formula. Now after this you have to see the molecular formula, and we are going to use this empirical formula to find out the molecular formula. So I'm going to you have to note this down in your fair copy, the numerical, so please keep noting. Now I'm going to erase this, and we'll find out the molecular formula. So let us see how to find out the molecular formula. So for finding molecular formula, we need a relation. We'll see a relationship, two relationships actually. Molecular weight is equal to 2 into vapor density. This is the first relationship, and molecular formula is equal to N into empirical formula. These are the two relations which we will be using to find out the molecular formula. Now see here, first we'll see this molecular formula is equal to N into empirical formula. This N is equal to this N is actually any integer, 1, 2, 3, 4, anything, so on, it can be any integer. So to find out N, what do we do? We divide molecular formula weight. Molecular formula weight means molecular weight upon empirical formula weight. Empirical formula weight. So we'll get the value of N, which will be 1, 2 or 3 or any number. So how can we get, now here we have to use empirical formula weight. So how can we get empirical formula weight? That I'm going to tell you. See, for calculating empirical formula weight, empirical formula is, I'm again writing here empirical formula, that is C2HCl3O. This is the empirical formula. So for finding out the empirical formula weight, what you will do, as you do to find out the molecular weight. So empirical formula weight will be number of atoms of each element into its atomic weight. So 2 into 12 plus 1 into 1, 1 is for hydrogen and its atomic weight is also 1. Then chlorine plus chlorine, 3 atoms into 35.5, plus oxygen, 16 into 1, there is only 1 atom. So this will be 24 plus 1 plus 106.5 plus 16, and it will be coming as 147.5. So this is 147.5. Empirical formula weight is 147.5. Now what we will do? I'm going to do it here. After this, I'm doing here. Okay? So after this, you can see here. It will come as, we are going to put this empirical formula weight into this formula. So N is equal to molecular formula weight upon empirical formula weight. Molecular formula weight, how do we get molecular formula weight? We know the vapor density. The vapor density is given in the question. So whenever this kind of numericals will be given, either the molecular weight will be given or the vapor density will be given. If molecular weight is given, you put directly over here. Molecular formula weight and molecular weight are the same thing. Molecular formula weight means weight you calculate by using molecular formula. So molecular formula weight upon empirical formula weight you have to do. Molecular formula weight you do not have. You have vapor density. So vapor density into 2 will give you molecular formula weight, and upon empirical formula weight, this is 2 into 73.75 upon 147.5. This will come as 147.5 upon 147.5 is equal to 1. That means value of N is equal to 1. Now, you put this n here in second equation. So, molecular formula will be n into empirical formula. Empirical formula is C2HCl3O. N is 1. 1 into C2HCl3O. This will be C2HCl3O. Since value of n over here is 1 only, that's why the same value of the empirical formula and molecular formula will be same here. Both of them are same. If the value would have been different, some of their molecular formula would have become different. But since n is 1 only, so molecular formula and empirical formula are same. Copy down this numerical. I'll give you one more numerical to practice in class in this duration only. And then I'll send you the solution of it. We'll do both the numericals in your notebooks and then send to your teachers. That is all for today, teachers.